Last week, I got sick. Now, hey, it wasn't the coronavirus, fortunately, but it was still an infection, some sort of coffee sneezing nonsense that ended up bringing me through a bit of a roller coaster in my blood sugar. Because it turns out that getting sick can often have a huge impact on your blood sugar. Most commonly, it'll raise your insulin resistance, maybe by a lot, and you'll have to deal with that. And today, I want to just talk about my experience that I've had this last week, how I managed it, and how you too can manage dealing with diabetes when you are sick. And I'm not talking about extreme sickness today. I'm not talking about vomiting, puking, anything like that. That's a whole different process. But if you're just mildly sick, if you have a cough or a sneeze or a fever or something like that, and it's nothing too serious, it's still more serious for a diabetic because now your blood sugar needs are going to suddenly change. Now you're going to need to change your insulin, and it can be a real mess for a while. It can be a tough transition. So let's talk about that. So as I said, when you get sick or you get an infection, whether it's a dental infection or it's a cough or a sneeze or whatever it is, you often end up having greater insulin resistance. And as we know, when you have higher insulin resistance, you have higher blood sugars. First thing you should do when you see this happen, don't panic. You're going to see these higher blood sugars and you're going to flip out. You might be blood sugars you haven't seen for a long time. Like, I had a blood sugar that was over 200. Now it's the first over 200 blood sugar I've had in like 9 months, right? So it was pretty disappointing to see that, waking up and seeing a 240, right? When I haven't had that kind of blood sugar in such a long time. But the important thing is to not panic. Don't freak out. Don't feel bad for yourself. Don't kick yourself thinking, oh, I'm so stupid. Oh, I got high blood sugar. It's not a big deal. Just get it fixed and keep moving along. So don't panic about it. Just deal with it and think about it rationally. Notice those patterns. Notice your blood sugar is rising throughout the day. What you're going to do, of course, is to raise your basal insulin. Raise the dose you take for your nighttime dose, your morning dose, whatever it is. Or if you're on a pump, raise that basal rate. But raise that long-acting insulin to the point where your blood sugars are at normal levels again. They're not spiking all day. Now, of course, if you're trying to change your medicine, it's important to ask your doctor and work with them about a dosing plan. But, I mean, let's be clear. I'm very experienced in this myself, and I didn't ask. I just did it. But that's okay. You know, my recommendation is to always ask. I'm not the expert here. I'm not a doctor. Don't ask me. Ask your doctor about changing your medicine. But you definitely should increase that basal insulin because you're going to be more insulin resistant. I was so much more insulin resistant when I got sick. I almost had to double my basal insulin. I went from 8 units a day to 14 units a day. That is how bad it got for me. And not only that, but I also had to raise my bolus insulin. I had to go from 3.5 units per meal to about 5 units per meal. And this took time, just like with any other change you make in diabetes, whether it's meals or whatever it is. It's all about experimenting. It's all about finding those patterns. So my biggest recommendation to you as far as changing insulin goes is to just check your blood sugar very often, use a CGM if you have one, and look for patterns and just slowly adjust your insulin up. Don't do it too fast because you don't want to go low, right? I didn't go from 8 units to 14 units. I brought up just 1 unit up a day at a time. You want to take it slowly, you know, a unit a day. And of course, judge how much you want to change it based on how drastic your highs are. If you're finding that you're going way up and you're not eating, you're just going way up, well, maybe you want to take a more drastic change. But in general, you don't want to go too fast. Slow and steady wins the race, because if you go too fast, or you're going to have a bunch of lows the next day, and that's not going to be any better. That's going to be even more dangerous, right? So take it slow and steady with the changes, whether it's your basal or your bolus, you know, just 1 unit at a time. Keep it easy and don't panic. Of course, another good technique is to always be drinking lots of fluids, because especially if your blood sugar is very high, you're at risk of ketoacidosis, and you don't want that to happen. You want to avoid that as much as possible. And also, drinking fluids is very good for dealing with fevers, especially with type 1 diabetes. So be sure to drink lots of fluids, don't panic, and be sure to adjust that insulin accordingly to get those blood sugars back down. it's very important that you get those blood sugars back down, because if you start going on that roller coaster again, you know, those highs aren't going to have a huge impact if it's just a few and you deal with them quickly. But if you're having those highs and you just stick with the same program, you let those highs last for weeks and weeks and weeks, that can have an impact. That's going to damage you. You want to avoid that kind of damage as much as possible. And so you want to get that insulin up. But again, do it slowly. Do it gradually. Don't take it too fast. Take it slow. You'll get there. Now, of course, there's going to be a time where you're not sick anymore. Your insulin just is going to go back down. And you're going to find that suddenly you're having lows. Just like before, where you had to raise your insulin, now start going back to lowering your insulin again. You might not end up where you originally were for months and months. It depends. So don't expect to go back to normal pretty quickly. But just take it one day at a time, focus on your numbers, and go according to that. Try not to have any expectations about it. But you notice yourself going low, lower that basal a bit, lower that bolus a bit. If you keep going low, keep lowering it. Don't go too fast with lowering it. Again, take it slowly. As long as you don't panic about it, as long as you do it gradually, as long as you're taking care of yourself, you should be able to manage getting sick with diabetes just fine. So that's the only tips I had today. I'll talk about the more serious illnesses like vomiting and dehydration later on. But those are some tips to keep in mind, and that's what I use to deal with these sickness while having my type 1 diabetes. See you next one, everyone. Keep taming that type 1.